part of the chapter. We were discussing about the Panchayati Raj. So we have already done the base level. If you remember, it was a triangular structure at the bottom of which were the villages under the Gram Panchayat. At the center, at the in the middle level, there were blocks under the Panchayat Samiti, and at the top level were Zilla Parishads, which are the local self-governing body of the districts. So we have already done the Gram Panchayats and the Block Samiti. So today we are basically talking about the Zilla Parishad. Since it is at the top of the triangular structure, we can say that the Panchayat Samiti or the Block Samiti, it acts as a link between the Gram Panchayat and the Zilla Parishad. And the Zilla Parishad, in turn, it acts as a link between the state government and the lower bodies like Panchayat Samiti and the Gram Panchayat. So basically, that is the thing. Each one of them, they are like a link which are connecting the top level to the bottom ones. Basically, that is what we are trying to say. This Zilla Parishad is also known by different names, such as the District Development Council. It is also called the Mahkuma Parishad, which is the Hindi name of the district. So all of these, they are the varied names. And again, these can come as one word answer, which of these is not a name for the Zilla Parishad. So the correct answers are District Development Council, Zilla Parishad and Mahkuma Parishad. These three are the names, and the fourth option will be incorrect automatically. So basically, when we are talking about the composition of the Zilla Parishad, the composition, basically it comprises between 40 to 60 members. And the highest member who is responsible for the functioning of the various levels of the Zilla Parishad is the Deputy Commissioner. Along with the Deputy Commissioner, the other members, they may be the president of the different Panchayat Samiti. Naturally, you know that different blocks together, they form a district. So every block will have its own Panchayat Samiti, and the chairperson, the president of that Panchayat Samiti, will automatically become a member of that Zilla Parishad. Similarly, the head of all the government departments, important departments like health, sanitation, HRA, or any other important departments which are there in that government, heads of those, they also become members of the Zilla Parishad. Like we had previously, members of legislative assemblies, MLAs or MPs, members of parliaments living in that particular district are also members of the Zilla Parishad. We had also discussed that some women and some members of scheduled caste and scheduled tribes are also members of the Zilla Parishad. And there are some co-opted members, that means members who are chosen. And these members, they may have an experience or achievement in a particular field. Since they are so experienced, they are included automatically in the Zilla Parishad. So basically somebody, some scientist or a person related to politics, or somebody who has done some kind of exemplary achievement in a particular field, they can become a member. So basically, when we talk about the composition, firstly, what is the Zilla Parishad? So it is the body which is the local self-governing body at the district level. It acts as a link between the state government and the lower bodies, Gram Panchayat and Panchayat Samiti. What is it also known as? District Development Council, Mahkuma Parishad and the Zilla Parishad. What is the composition? So it has 40 to 60 members comprising of the Deputy Commissioner, the President of all the Panchayat Samitis, the heads of all the government departments, MLAs, MPs, women, scheduled caste, and some co-opted member who have some exemplary performance or achievement in any public sphere. Basically, the office bearers are the same as the Panchayat Samiti. So there is a chairperson who presides, who chairs all the meetings, and he conducts the proceeding, how the meeting is to proceed. All of that he looks after, and he is elected among the members themselves. So from among the members of the Zilla Parishad, they choose a person as their leader, as their head, who will preside them, and that is the chairman. The chairman is helped by a deputy chairperson who will preside the meetings in the absence of the chairman. So they are also elected by the members themselves. So they choose, like you choose the captain and the vice captain. So the members of the Zilla Parishad, they choose the chairman and the deputy chairperson. The state appoints an officer just like previously called the secretary to keep a track of everything which is happening, who is a fully paid employee, who is paid by the state government. So the paid employee by the state government is the secretary, and the other two, chairperson and deputy chairperson, are elected from among the members themselves. Now, what are the functions of the Zilla Parishad? So basically, the Zilla Parishad itself is a very, very regular working body. That means it does a lot of work, especially regarding the coordinating of the Panchayat Samiti and the other bodies. It performs very important work. And it works through standing committees. What are these standing committees? So they are basically permanent bodies which have some important function which is given to them. So there are various such standing bodies through which this Zilla Parishad works. and these standing bodies is also made of panchayat district boards. So there are district boards that look into the work of the different panchayat which is working under that particular district. Then there are standing committees which hold meetings as to what is to be done regarding the panchayat samiti and the district samiti. And there are some working committees which actually do the work. So like you can understand that the legislature in the union government, it makes the laws, but the actual work is done by the executive. So similarly, the standing committee, it makes all the rules and it discusses and takes the decisions, and the working committee does all the actual work. So what will be the function of this Zilla Parishad? So basically, since it is above the Gram Panchayat and the Panchayat Samiti, it will oversee the all-round work which is being done by the different Panchayat Samiti which is under that Zilla, under that district. And this work is supervised by the Deputy Commissioner, who is the highest officer in the Zilla Parishad. So under his supervision, all the Panchayat Samitis are overseen by the Zilla Parishad. Secondly, like we mentioned, the standing committees, they have the chairperson and the deputy chairperson. So they together, they hold the meetings, they take decisions, and the different district boards, they are also a part of the standing committee when the decisions are taken. After the decision is taken, the working committee acts as the executive, actual working body of the district board, and does all the work. The fourth function, it supervises the working of the different panchayat samitis under it, which is natural because the Zilla Parishad is made up of the different panchayat samitis. So it supervises the work and it guides them. Fifth one, in some states like Assam, Bihar, they also keep a track of the budget. That means the Zilla Parishad, it keeps a track of the budget which is allotted by the state to the Panchayat Samiti and the Gram Panchayat, just to make sure that the money is not wasted and it is being used appropriately for the things which are required. Then the sixth one, it coordinates the important work of the Panchayat Samiti. So provide, it makes sure that the Panchayat Samitis are providing development work and basic amenities such as sanitation, irrigation work, vocational and industrial schools. So basically vocational and industrial schools are those schools where the children learn some skills and arts through which they can earn some money, like driving, stitching, these kind of skills they may learn for making money. So village industries, cottage industries through which income can be generated, public health, all of these kind of spheres, the Zilla Parishad will guide the Panchayat Samiti as to and it will coordinate with the Panchayat Samiti and make sure that these development in these particular fields like irrigation, sanitation, public health and vocational and industrial schools is being done or not. And lastly, basically since it is connecting the state government with the other bodies, so it can advise the state government on matters relating to Gram Panchayat and the Panchayat Samiti. So it can, on behalf of the Gram Panchayat and the Panchayat Samiti, it can ask for more funds for a particular program, or it can, you know, convey their problems to the state government since it is acting as a link between them. So I hope these functions are clear to all of you. In today's class, the achievements are not a part of the syllabus. So in today's class, we have finished the chapter. If you look at the table which is given on page 155, it is basically a recapitulation. It's just talking about the composition and the functions and who are the office bearers in the Gram Panchayat, in the Panchayat Samiti and the Zilla Parishad. If you have understood the chapter and you read this table, it should be crystal clear to you because it is just a repetition of all that I have already taught. So in Zilla Parishad, please be careful. It is also, it is the local self-governing body at the district level, the top of the triangular structure. It acts as a link between the state government and the lower bodies of Gram Panchayat and Panchayat Samiti. It is also called the District Development Council or the Mahkuma Council Parishad. It has 40 to 60 members headed by a deputy commissioner and other members such as MPs, MLAs, women, SCST and other members. Office bearers are chairman, deputy chairperson and the paid secretary who is paid by the state. And the different functions we just did, such as the overall functioning of the Panchayat Samitis under the deputy commissioner is seen. There are standing committees that conduct meetings regarding the functioning. There are working committees which actually execute the plans of the district board. In some states like Bihar and Assam, they also make an estimate of the budget. They also supervise the Panchayat Samiti as to the work which is doing. It assists them in development work such as sanitation and public work. And lastly, it advises the state relating to the problems of Gram Panchayat and the Panchayat Samiti. So I hope this chapter on local self-governing bodies is very, very clear to you. Local self-governing bodies are basically, it is like a realization of the dreams of Mahatma Gandhi. He always believed very strongly that at the grassroots level, at the lowest level, people have to have power, because that is when it can be called as a true actual democracy, when everybody at the local, even at the smallest level, they have some power to administer themselves. So that is what the government is trying to do, because it's not practically possible for the central government to reach out to everyone. So these local self-governing bodies are very effective in the functioning, and it helps the central and the state government and reduces their burdens tremendously. So read this chapter properly. It will be questioned in your examinations in the second UT also and the final term. Read the chapter. I hope it's clear to all of you. Thank you.